Hi, I'm Caitlin Ryan with Cognizant. Welcome to our Healthcare Interoperability Ask the Expert video series. Today, Adrian DeWitt, Director of Product Portfolio Strategy, will be answering a few questions about the TriZetto Interoperability Adapter. Adrian, what HL7 FHIR standard is required by the interoperability rules?
So the interoperability rules proposed by CMS and ONC outline that the HL7 FHIR standard of 4.0.1 should be applied. And then as well as that being the base FHIR standard that's there, there are also additional implementation guides surrounding the way that those FHIR resources should be used. So within a FHIR resource, there can be an implementation guide, such as the one published by USCDI, which is mandatory for the clinical data, where a profile is defined that has rules for how to implement some of those base FHIR resources.
How does the interoperability adapter translate data and normalize terminology?
So within the adapter, the main purpose is to transform the data to the FHIR 4.0.1 standard, as well as perform any of the necessary terminology normalizations. And what we mean by terminology normalizations is where we have different value sets, let's say for marital status in a source system. FHIR has their own value sets, and so performing that terminology normalization. So within the adapter, when requests come in, the adapter has the capability to reach back into Facets using the open access services or through QNXT using the QXI services. It retrieves that data in its QNXT or Facets form, but then once it's returned back into the adapter then takes that, maps it to the appropriate FHIR data elements, and then performs that terminology normalization. That terminology normalization will also be able to be customized through a screen where if there are different source values or values that you have configured in either of our core admin systems differently than what the standard mapping is based on, then those can be configured to then at real time be transformed into the appropriate FHIR values.
Does the adapter deliver on-demand data translation?
Yes, so within the adapter, the on-demand data translation happens real-time. So as soon as there's a request that's made and we go retrieve that information out of QNXT and Facets, that data is only then transformed and terminology normalized into the appropriate FHIR standard. The adapter itself doesn't have any type of a data storage component, so all that transformation is done on-demand.
Does the adapter work in real-time?
Yes, the adapter is absolutely real time. So only as requests come in, and those are going to be coming through some sort of an external API gateway. So they don't represent the actual external API calls that a third party developer is making on behalf of a member or their authorized representatives. But when that request gets routed to the adapter, it in real time then goes and requests that information from our core admin systems to then perform the data translation and terminology normalization into FHIR.
Thanks, Adrian, and thanks for joining us. You can learn more about our interoperability solutions by visiting cognizant.com/interoperability, and look for more Ask the Expert videos coming soon.